Open the UV editing workspace. We have UV wrapped the barrel in the previous video. So the barrel has this nice UV map ready for texturing. Click on UV, export UV layout. Choose the location. I will call it barrel UV. Set the size to 2K. Format to PNG. And export UV layout. Open our barrel UV PNG using GIMP. Let's create a new layer. I will call it walls. Move walls layer below barrel UV and select barrel UV layer. Enable fuzzy select tool. Click on the barrel wall UV island to make the selection. If you can't select the whole UV island, set the threshold to a bigger value. With UV island selected, right click, select, grow. Set it to 10 pixels. Now our selection growth by 10 pixels. Select walls layer. Enable bucket fill tool. Set foreground color to a light wood color. And fill in the color on the walls layer. Now we have a base color layer for the barrel wall, which we will be using during texturing process. Again, select the barrel UV layer, enable fuzzy select tool, and select the barrel top part. Right click, select, grow. Set it to 10 pixels. Selection is a bit too close to our UV island. Ctrl Z to redo. And set it to 7 pixels. Make sure that selection doesn't overlap with UV islands from other parts. This will do. Create a new layer. Top. Let's move it down. And fill it with the same wood color. Again, select the barrel UV layer, make selection, grow selection by 7 pixels, create a new layer, bottom, and fill in using the same color. Do the same thing with the lid. Right click, select, none, to deselect everything. Create a new layer BG for the background color. Move it to the bottom. Let's hide barrel UV layer. Choose a bit lighter color. And fill in the color on the BG layer. Let's test it inside the blender. File, save as. Let's save a GIMP file first so we don't lose our progress. Now file, export as. I will call it barrel albedo. Export as PNG. Open Blender. Click on a folder icon and choose our barrel albedo PNG texture. And it is applied to the barrel. Tap to enter the edit mode. A to select all UV islands. and apply viral albedo.png texture to the UV window. We will be using this later on for refreshing the image to apply texture changes. Back to GIMP. Create a new layer metal. Unhide viral UV layer. Enable rectangle select tool. And select this viral UV part. Make sure that selection matches with UV map lines. And it goes to the very edge of the site. I'm happy with my selection. Select the metal layer and fill in with a gray color. Fill in the color and do the same for the other metal part. Make a selection. Create a new layer, metal bottom. Let's also rename metal to metal top. Select the metal bottom and fill in the color. Right click, select none to deselect everything. Hide barrel UV layer and save the changes to barrel albedo.png to overwrite the file. Export to barrel albedo.png. Back to Blender. By default, Blender won't refresh the texture changes. Hover your mouse on the UV window and press Alt R to refresh the texture changes. You need to do this every time you make some changes to your texture file. Back to GIMP. Enable Path Tool. Unhide barrel UV layer. Left click to add a point at the corner of the UV map. And add another point at the bottom corner to make a straight line. Make sure that the path line is following the UV map line. Now open the Paths tab. Make sure that the path is visible. Duplicate the path. With a new path selected, Alt left click to move the path. Move it to the middle of the next UV line. Again, duplicate the path. Alt left click to move the path. Do this for all vertical UV map lines. Right click, merge visible paths to merge all into one. Let's call it walls highlight. Left click on the path to select it. Little spheres indicate that the path is selected. Go back to the layers tab. Create a new layer, walls highlight. Make sure that the layer is above the walls layer and below the metal layers. With walls highlight layer selected, hide barrels UV layer. Choose the lighter wood color. Use the color picker to pick wall color and make it a bit lighter. Click on stroke path. Set line width to 20 pixels and click stroke. If you zoom in, you can see we have some nice highlight lines. If you want to see it better, choose any other tool so we don't see the path selection. And hide our wood highlight paths. So now we can see the texture better. Let's unhide the path. Enable the path tool and select the path. Create a new layer walls shadow. Set color to a darker wood color. Stroke path. Set line width to 10 pixels. And click stroke. Again, hide the path and select the move tool to see the texture better. Now we have a nice and simple wood planks separated with highlight and shadow lines. Go to File, Export, and overwrite our barrel albedo PNG. Open Blender, Alt R to refresh the image, and here we have a nice barrel made out of wood planks. Let's do the same to the top and bottom parts. Back to GIMP, unhide the barrel UV, select the path tool, click to add a point here, and here at the end. Make sure that the path is following the line. Hold shift left click to add a new path point. Left click to continue adding path points. Do the same for all of these lines where the wood planks should be separated. Unhide the path and rename it to Top Highlight. Select Top Highlight path. Create a new layer, Top Highlight. Make sure that it is above the top layer. Hide barrel UV layer. Choose this color we used previously, or use a color picker. Stroke path. Set line width to 20 pixels. And stroke. Create a new layer, top shadow. Make sure that it's above the top highlight layer. Choose this color we used previously. Stroke path. Set line width to 10 pixels, stroke. File, export to barrel albedo PNG. And test it in Blender, see how it looks on the barrel. Back to GIMP. Duplicate the top highlight layer. Rename it to bottom highlight. And move it above the bottom layer. Enable the move tool. Set move to layer and choose move the active layer. Move the bottom highlight on top of the barrel top. Align that with a barrel UV map. You can use arrow keys to move it slightly to any side. Do the same with a bottom highlight layer. Hide barrel UV layer. Save the texture. Back to Blender. Alt R to refresh the texture changes. Everything aligns perfectly. Back to GIMP. Let's add some highlights to the sharp areas of the barrel. Create a new layer above the metal top layer and call it metal highlight. Enable the path tool and create a path on this line. Unhide and duplicate the path. Alt left click to move the path. Move it on the second UV line. Make sure that only these two paths are visible. Right click, merge visible paths. Let's call it metal top highlight. I will also rename the layer metal highlight to metal top highlight. Hide the barrel UV. Choose a lighter metal color. Select the path. Stroke path. Line width 10 pixels. Here is our metal highlight. Do the same with the bottom metal part. Duplicate the metal top highlight path. Rename it to metal bottom highlight. Alt left click to move the path. Make sure it follows UV lines. Above the metal bottom, create a new layer, metal bottom highlight. Stroke path. Metal highlight is done. Save changes. Back to Blender, Alt R, refresh texture changes. The barrel is getting into shape. Let's add a highlight to the barrel top and the bottom. Back to GIMP. Let's organize our layers by creating a few layer groups. Click on this folder icon to create a new layer group. Call it bottom and add a bottom layers inside. Do the same for other barrel part layers. This is how I organized all of my layers. Above the top layer, create a new layer, top highlight. Create a new path around the top of the barrel. Ctrl left click to connect the path. Pick a wood highlight color. Stroke path. Save and test it in Blender. We need to add the same highlight to the side of this edge. If this is the edge, padiu vesim for the bottom edge. Save and test it in Blender. Now we have a nice highlight on both sides of the edge. Let's finish adding highlights to the top edges. Top highlights are done. Save and test it in Blender. I will change the roughness to 0.8 so the barrel is not that shiny. Let's copy and paste the top highlight to the bottom. Ctrl C to copy the top highlight layer, Ctrl V to paste it. Click on the green icon to confirm. Rename to bottom highlight. And move it on top of the bottom barrel part. Copy and paste another top highlight layer. Save and test it in Blender. Top and the bottom highlights are done. Let's add highlights for the lid edges. Ctrl left click to connect the path. Shift left click to add a new path. This time I will set the line width to 5 pixels. Save and test it in Blender. All highlighted parts are done. Let's add some text on the barrel wall. Select the text tool. I will write a barrel. The font I used is called Acme Font Thin. I set the font size to 156 pixels. Save and test it in Blender. I'm happy with the font and the size, but I want to make it darker. Ctrl A to select the text and choose a darker wood color. The clean version is done. Now let's add some dirt. Create a new layer, dirt. For dirt, I have used a little darker wood color. Enable the paintbrush tool. I used Grunge 01 brush. I want to paint only on the wall layer. So right click on the wall layer and select Alpha to Selection. Now we can only paint inside the selection. Select the dirt layer and paint. I am using the eraser to erase some dirt parts. Turn down the opacity to something like 60%. Save and test it in Blender. Let's add some wear to the text. Let's add some wear to the text. And add a mask. With a mask selected, set color to black. And paint on the text to add some wear. Try out some different brushes. Let's add some dirt to the metal parts too. Right click, Alpha to Selection, to make a metal bottom layer selection. Move the dirt layer above the metal bottom highlight to make it more realistic. And don't forget to lower the opacity. Do the same to the metal top part. Move the dirt layer above the wall highlight. It makes it look more realistic. Save and test it in Blender. Looks so much better with that dirt and wear. Let's add some dirt here to make it even more realistic. For this, I set opacity to 70%. I selected the eraser and erased the dirt where the shadow line is. Duplicate the layer and move it on top of the top metal part. It looks a bit off, so let's scale it down from the top and the bottom. Select the scale tool. Make sure that the keep aspect is disabled. Scale it down and use move tool to move it to the place. Save and test it in Blender. Very minimal effect, but it adds to the whole dirty barrel look. Now let's add some dirt to the top and bottom parts. From this point you can do it by yourself. Just make a new layer, make a top layer selection, pick a brush and paint some dirt. Save and test it in Blender. Do the same with the bottom. Right click, select None. Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste. Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste. I made the bottom dirt a bit more intense. Let's add some dirt to the lid too. Save and test it in Blender. We are almost done. Let's add the final detail, some deep metal scratches. Add a new layer, metal scratch. Select the path tool. move the metal scratch layer above the metal top highlight. Ctrl left click to connect the path. Stroke path at 5 pixels. Choose a darker color to fill the inside. Add a new layer below the metal scratch. Fill path. And here we have a simple metal scratch effect. Save and test it in Blender. I think I need to move it down a bit. I will erase the part where it's on the wood. Something like that. I will also move the scratch to the side. I will add two more scratches. And it's done. Save and test it in Blender. We are done with the texturing part. Let's create a quick lighting setup to preview the barrel. Open the layout workspace. Enable the renderer viewport shading. Add a sunlight. Set the intensity to 5. Let's also add a plane. Open the world properties and choose the lighter color shade. Enable ambient occlusion and improve the shadow quality. Select the sun and set the angle to 3 to make the shadow softer. That's it. In the next video, I will show you how to export the barrel to Unity. Continue by watching part 4. And don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more.